matters, I'm gelating. Back and forth, but it's too late. What's up, beautiful humans? Miss Ngaywa here. It is yet another episode that I have made. I hope you do enjoy and be glad in it. Well, leo kidogo ni jintroduce as Madam Ngaywa, but mneza kwa confused. It's just Miss Ngaywa. As usual, well, I hope you have been well. Mekuwa poa. This weather iko tu sawa, but I hope you have been well. Yes, particularly you. Yes, you. I am speaking to you. I hope umekuwa poa. And kama haujakuwa poa, it's just Tuesday, the beginning of the week. And it's yet kuna another opportunity for you to start over, to start again. And if you do care about how I have been, if you do care, well, I have been exhausted. Kwanza iwiki, I have just been tired. Life is moving at 10 kilometers per hour. Nami bado I'm in the first 1,000 kilometers. I mean, the first 1,000th part of the 10 kilometers. So I'm just playing catch up with life, and it's kind of exhausting. Anyway, happy new month. I want to think that by the time you're listening to this episode, it's a new month, August, and happy new month to you. Yeah, itakuwa, hopefully, I think itakuwa a new month. And maybe the 5th atakuwa shaingia. I mean, apart from wajakoya, the actual 5th. See, ati simanishi that wajakoya is not the 5th. But maybe the 5th atakuwa meingia. If you do not understand by what I mean by the 5th, to my abroad listeners, if I do have any. Is it gonna make assumptions and I do not have abroad listeners? To my other country listeners, yeah, the 5th is that the country of Kenya is electing or has elected its 5th president, so hence the 5th, and Wajako is just the 5th by default. And we are currently experiencing the reign of a new president. We are yet to experience the reign of a new president, and this might bring maybe uncertainty, a little bit of anxiety. New things bring a little bit of anxiety to some people. What wengine wamezoea new things, good for yalls, but for some of us, new things zinatupatianga some little bit or a lot of anxieties. So we do not know what to expect with the elections coming, with the new president. Ama, we already know what to expect. I mean, situmezoya, wanasemanga, and they don't do those things. But ni 2022 August, we have not lived 2022 August yet. We are yet to see. So it being us experiencing a new president, I would like to now introduce the title of this episode, The New People Anxiety. The last episode we talked about new place anxiety. So today we are talking about new people anxiety. And acha tu ilete into perspective. Probably in a week you definitely experience new people in your interactions, right? Inaweza kuwa kwa mat, msi ame decide leo I want to talk to you. In a mat, someone you do not know. Kama ni mimi, I'd be like, please, let's not do this. You're putting too much pressure on me to respond to you. And it's too early in the morning. I do not interact with people very early in the morning. But 9 out of 10 times in a week, or maybe 8, we do experience new people or new interactions in our lives. And the level of interaction doesn't really matter, but niati, we do get to meet new people at a certain frequency in our lives. And kama uko kama mimi, apart from interacting with people, interacting with new people gives me a lot of heebie-jeebies. That to mean anxieties. And mainly inakuanga, what do we talk about? Unakana mtu chini, so tutongelelea nini? Kwa sababu I do not like to talk about myself. Sometimes, ama most times, I would be anxious about what to talk about, or what are our levels of interactions? Ama, should I talk or should I not talk? I'm usually a quiet person. Imagine you could be hearing me chatting here, making your Saturday, your Tuesday morning, evening or afternoon, but I am usually a quiet person. So with new interaction, I usually question kama, should I talk or should I not talk? Ama, should I smile? Am I smiling a lot? Is my, you know, my silent face or my chilled face a little bit scary? Unajua? I don't know. Like, what do they expect of me? Those things, ndo zinafanyanga, I get anxieties and it's really exhausting. And more often than not, we rarely have a choice of being amongst people. So, atunanga your opportunity. Maybe sometimes when you have to go to work, it's a new job opportunity, you have to be there and you're working with people if you're not working remotely. And blessed are you, ama lucky are you if you actually do get to work remotely kusababu you don't have to interact with people. But if you do have to interact with people, then hauna choice. Lazima, you have to play a certain thing. You have to be a certain way for you to be accommodated in that particular space. For me, the level of interactions definitely dictate my level of involvement or my participation with those people around me. So, kama nimekuja kazi, then I will have to play the part of being, of someone being in a work of place. But more often than not, where money is involved, believe me, I'll play the part really well. I think I can be a paid actor. I want to think so. So kama pesa iko involved in meeting new people, I'll definitely play the part, because money rules everything around us. But on another note, the dynamics of life rarely give you the opportunity to not be a team player, especially where team play is involved. But if you do get an opportunity to choose when and when not to be participative, imagine, take it. Kwa sababu kama ni mimi, I will take it. Mimi, I am more of being by myself, working by myself, doing things by myself. But imagine in an organization there are responsibilities that you have to handle. Most of the times you know what to do. Ama, when you go somewhere, if it's not the first time you're experiencing that thing, I mean, that atmosphere or that whatever is being done there, you already know what is expected of you. And I think when you know your expectations, that will put you at ease a little bit, will ease your nervousness or anxieties and hautakuwa issues as much. So when it is inevitable for you to be in a new space or to be amongst new people, what are some of the things that you can do? One of them is that you can learn people. You can learn their mannerisms, especially in that particular environment that you're in. You can learn how they speak, their intonation, kama wako rude or their calm. You can learn how they, you can see, observe how they address people around them. People higher than them in authority, or people niseme lua, or people who are not particularly in their level. You can see and observe how they treat them and how they handle their responsibilities, what they do and how they do whatever they do. And even their undertones. I believe I mentioned this in the previous episode, that I believe that people usually speak in an undertone. None of those things that nika inasemwa but haisemwi. Someone is saying something but not in words. Those are undertones. Pay attention to those. And another thing is that, how do you respond or react to people? Most of the times, it's not that our watu ni wa annoying or you hate them or they're just unbearable. It's usually how we react to people. And you could learn the circumstances surrounding your reaction to them. Maybe mtu, the last time mtu alikuongelesha kwa mat alikuambia some disgusting shite. That is why if anyone starts to speak to you in a matatu, you're like, pull up, this is not it, just stop, kwa sababu I would not know how to speak to you. And also you could try to understand what really irks you or what excites you around new people. Some people wakikuja kuongelesha new to you, when they come to speak to you, I mean, they are a vibe. You guys can actually have a dope conversation, a flowing conversation. You can, please don't force yourself into this part of my, but pay attention to how you react to those people, to new people. Some people wanna find